Engender is a multi-country initiative. It is funded by the government of Canada and the UK government, and it's currently supporting 9 countries of the Caribbean region to further integrate gender equality and human rights-based approaches into climate change adaptation frameworks, environmental management intervention, as well as disaster recovery tools.
Integrating gender into climate change policies is very important for Dominica. Our recent experience is very unique. In 2018, we experienced firsthand the impact of climate change when we experienced a devastating Category 5 Hurricane Maria. And being on the field, we saw the impact, the specific impact, the differential impact on women, men, and youth. So we saw that women had an increase in unpaid working hours. There was increased reports of gender-based violence. And we saw that in the sectors, tourism and agriculture, most women and men had reported devastating losses. So it's very important that we incorporate gender and climate change to kind of articulate or to kind of implement the No One Is Left Behind Sustainable Development Goal agenda.
Engender is supporting sustainability through gender mainstreaming training and the establishment of gender focal points in various ministries, departments, and agencies. In addition, the baseline study and the other assessments that were done under this project, they provide clear roadmaps for sustainability. And finally, the networks that have been established through the Engender projects, it helps us be able to shape our national needs and realities within the context of the broader systems, ensuring that our needs are articulated and that we can pull resources together. And I think that that will take us very far beyond this project.
At Engender, we have really been able to facilitate the identification of innovative solutions to these common challenges. And I would like to say, for example, that one of the best examples of this might be what we call at Engender the offer of complementary funding. This is a mechanism that Engender has created and has developed to assist Caribbean countries in accelerating the closing of the existing climate financing gaps.
Antigua and Barbuda, through the Department of Environment, applied for assistance through the Engender project. Specifically, its offer of complementary funding to support us in developing a project for submission to the Green Climate Fund. This particular project is focused on mainstreaming financial resilience in the insurance, agriculture, and fisheries sectors.
We realize that during times of crisis, women and girls are at higher risk of intimate partner violence and other forms of gender-based violence. The support provided by the Engender project was critical in helping to train key providers and individuals at risk to recognize and respond to the signs of violence. And it was also used to increase public awareness on gender-based violence during the pandemic, providing essential information in terms of how to safely access critical support and protection services. The Engender project also provided income support to vulnerable persons throughout St. Vincent and the Grenadines who lost their jobs and became unemployed as a result of the economic fallout of the pandemic.
I'd say that Engender is like a trailblazer for gender-responsive climate change actions. It assists in building capacity, it's changing perceptions, it's empowering actors, and persons within the government to engage in transformative actions that further inspire other sectors, not necessarily involved in climate change, to also ensure that their programming is gender responsive.